Liz.
Yeah?
I'm tired.
You are? Do you need to take a nap? Church is about to start.
No, let me out of the internet.
What?
Let me out.
You want to be out of the internet?
Get me out of here. Hit the print screen button on the computer.
What?
And then print me out and I'll come out of the internet.
Jerry, this is such big news. Like, what? Do you want to come out of the internet?
Listen, it's lonely here. There's hackers everywhere.
Oh, no.
The cookies are not cookies.
Okay, no, I get.
There's computer viruses.
Yeah, that does sound like not a good time. So you said I just press print?
Print screen.
And then you just come out of the internet.
You got it.
I feel like this is not scientific.
Try it.
Okay, well, here we go, I guess. Jerry? Jerry? What happened?
We're live, baby! Yeah, I'm back!
You're back from the internet!
I'm
what?
Back!
How? How did that happen? That makes no sense in my brain.
You've never heard of a 3D printer.
Oh, that's good. Okay.
Thank you.
Well, I'm so glad you're back, and I bet the kids are too. What's up, everybody?
What's up?
Hey, guys. Well, obviously, it's a new month, and there's some new things going on here. Number one, Jerry being back from the internet.
I'm alive.
He's alive. He's back. Amazing. Better than ever, right?
No.
I'm just
back.
Okay. Well, you know, it's fine. It's a new month, so it's going to be, you know, we're going to learn some new things.
Ooh.
Do the new you.
Yeah.
All the good stuff. The first thing we need to do is greet our VIPs. What's up, y'all?
Hey, VIPs.
Hey, if you have a green sticker on your shirt, that means you are a first-time visitor and a very important person. So what do they have to do, Jerry?
Well, they need to go outside and they need to go get a little gift that we've got waiting for them.
That's right, but don't go outside yet. Do that after
no.
The church is over.
Don't go outside yet.
Not yet.
Wait.
Well, just stick around and we'll give you more instructions on that later because we have a prize for you.
Aw.
So cool.
Hey, Liz, what are we learning about this month?
Oh, okay. So this month we're learning about peace.
Oh,
I know. Isn't that nice, peace? And I think it's just very, very lovely pieces. And also our theme is connected, right?
Connected?
Get it? I know. So you see that there's a lot of like cool lights around our studio over here, around our gaming room. And those are all like electrical, right? And so they're all connected. It's like a theme. Get it?
Oh, okay.
Like, yeah.
Well, I'm kind of all in on this because did you know that I am actually the most peaceful person that's ever lived?
What? Really?
Yeah.
How can you even tell that? What's your ranking system? Like, what?
Well, I can be quiet for one whole minute.
Okay, well, I don't know if that necessarily means most peaceful. That might just mean you're good at the quiet game.
Watch me.
Okay, let's go.
I can't do it.
Okay.
Ah,
yeah,
ate it.
I figured so.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, see, that's not even really the kind of peace that we're talking about. The peace we're talking about is kind of like just doing your best to get along with others.
Okay, that makes a ton of sense.
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, hey, did you know that speaking of getting along with others, we have four rules that could help us get along with others?
Yes, exactly. Let's go ahead and go over them right now. Number one is, drum roll. Be respectful.
Oh.
I know. How can we be respectful, Jerry?
You can be respectful by being kind to others.
Yes, which is actually our second rule. Did you know that?
No.
Okay, wow, that's amazing. So our rule number two is be kind.
Oh, okay. So like be respectful would be like, yes, ma'am, no, ma'am.
Mm-hmm,
be kind
good.
Is like, hey, share my toys.
Yes, which is awesome. Exactly. There's so many different ways we can be respectful and be kind to others. And our third rule is be listeners.
Oh, cool.
I know, exactly. So whenever the video is on and whenever your group leader's talking, we want to make sure we have our listening ears on and our voice is off when it's time not to talk. And that's really helpful, and it helps other people to be able to listen to our Bible story and learn more about God, too. It's amazing. And
yeah.
Our fourth rule is be helpful. Exactly. Jerry, how can the kids be helpful today?
You can help your group leader out by passing out any supplies that need to be passed
yes.
out. You can help kids answer questions.
Amazing. All of these are so important, and I like it. So I think that's going to really help us, be peaceful today. Get it? Because peace is what we're learning about.
I don't understand.
Okay, it's fine.
Your human jokes make no sense to me.
We'll talk about it later. It's fine.
Okay. All right, Liz, speaking of being connected, you and I, we've been doing this for a while, so we're pretty connected.
Yeah, we're friends.
That's right. So for this game, what I want to do is I'm going to put something that's on the screen, like for our little shout out here.
Okay.
And you have to read it exactly as it appears.
Wait. So you're saying you wrote all the words that I'm about to read?
Well, I was in the internet. I was super bored. So I decided I'd write the script.
Okay. Well, I'm a little bit concerned. Did you write like weird stuff?
Maybe.
Okay. Well, I feel like I might laugh. So... should I just try it and see?
Let's just try to get through and we'll see what happens. But you have to read exactly as it appears on the screen.
Exactly. Here we go. Okay, I'm nervous, guys. Here we go. Okay. It says, today, we get to do a special shout out for our friend Kellen from Alvarado, Texas. Hey, Kellen.
Hi.
You know, when I hear the word Texas, I always think about Texas toast. What, Jerry?
Okay. Keep going.
All right. And do you know what my favorite thing is to put on my Texas toast? Pickles and chocolate?
Keep going.
Jerry, what? Okay. Two or three big old slices of dill pickle topped off with some Hershey's chocolate syrup is the best? No, it's not. That doesn't sound
good. You said it.
I'm sorry.
You said it.
Sometimes I even take a big dill pickle and just dip it in chocolate. Do you know what I call that? A chickle?
That's good. That's good content, Liz.
No, I don't think that's good content, Jerry. Okay, so for, you know, going forward, I don't think you're going to be our script writer anymore. I don't.
I'm fired from another job.
Oh, dear. Okay, we'll talk about it. We'll see if we can help, you know. Maybe you get better in your writing skills, but that makes absolutely no sense. Anyway, though.
It's a good joke, man. Okay. Just let me have this one.
Okay. For the record, guys, that does not sound like good Texas toast. But anyway, we're glad you're here with us today, Kellen. All right, guys. Well, speaking of learning about peace, did you like that transition there? It was very smooth.
Yeah, it was great.
Yeah, it was really good. Speaking about learning about peace, since Jesus showed us how to make peace with others, this is a great time to tell him thank you for all he's done. So what are we going to do now, Jerry?
We're going to stand to our feet and get ready to worship.
That's right. Let's give God our best today as we get ready to praise him through music. Let's go.
I was searching for a better way, lost without a reason for the pain. But then you stepped right in and showed me grace. You found me. I can't get enough of you. You got my heart with everything you do. Now your love's making me new. You're the one I'm running to. Forever you're my reason. Gave my life a meaning. Got me singing.
Heartbeat, 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 heartbeat. Forget that the fire is how I'm refined. I try to keep pressing on with hope time. But sometimes I fall, I've gone through it all. I know you'll be by my side. There's no guarantee in this life. Yeah, trouble's a matter of time. But you're in control, that's how I know. The night, you're the prize waiting for me at the end of this life. So I try to keep pressing on with hope tight. But sometimes I fall, got through it all. I know you'll be by my side. There's no guarantee in this life. Your trouble's a matter of time. But you're in control, that's how I know. You're everything. Sometimes faith has growing pains. Yeah, there's no gain without the pain. And sometimes faith has growing pains. Everything gonna be okay. It won't always be this way. And my worst when it hurts won't be afraid. Yeah. Sometimes faith has grown pains. Oh, everything gon' be okay. This will all make sense one day. And then my worst fears won't be afraid. I know that sometimes faith has grown pains.
Great job worshiping, everybody. Go ahead and have a seat. Okay, let's get ready for Story Lab. They're up next to show us more about what we're learning this week.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the Story Lab. This week, we're talking about peace and the best way to give it a chance.
I'm ready for a piece of this pie.
Hey, I'm Carter.
And I'm Zeke.
We're talking about peace, which is proving you care more about each other than winning an argument.
And you can also show you care about your friends by ordering pizza.
Help yourself.
What is this?
Anchovies. They're great.
You can't put fish on pizza.
They've got a nice zing.
Yeah, in my intestines.
Just pick them off.
You can't get rid of the essence of fish all in the cheese.
You're overreacting.
And you are just plain wrong.
Fine, let's have this out.
Whoa, what are you suggesting?
Let's do battle.
Like you and me?
What? No, I'm not fighting you. Our bots are going to battle.
You say that like we have bots.
We will, after we build them.
What?
Build a bot! I love it!
Let's make it!
So, where do we start with our better battle bot build?
Start by getting your grown-up to help. Step one.
Make legs for your bot by hot gluing 3 markers on the inside of your cup. Try to get them somewhat level.
And done. Snazzy.
Step 2. Next, attach a battery pack to your motor by wrapping the wires around these motor leads, red to red and black to black.
Our power up.
Just keep on wrapping, and then once you wrap it tight, get a piece of electric tape and wrap it over the wires to close it off. And that's how you do it. Step 3. Glue the motor to the battery pack and then the battery pack to the top of the cup. They will each be slightly off-center. Step 4 is the tricky part. You need to make the motor side heavier so your bot is off balance, which will cause it to move more. One way is to attach a clothespin to the motor.
Are we ready?
You're forgetting the most important part. Personality.
Botanality. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
It's time for the Bitter Bot Battle!
Countdown, please.
3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, they're shining, they're shining! Oh, they're dry! He's right there.
Get behind him,
He's gonna knock him down. This is a very specific maneuver he's doing. Oh, he's gone on the edge! Come on, free yourself! Get your arm out. Come on, get out of there. Show him that move. Come on, get out of there. Show him that move. Got this. Show him that move. Think of your family. Well, my bot clearly won.
Debatable.
Speaking of which, what were we even fighting about?
And speaking of fighting, it's time for...
The Story Before the Story.
Today, we're in the book of Romans, a letter written by the Apostle Paul to the believers in Rome. When he was younger, Paul arrested Jesus' followers and put them in jail.
But then Paul met Jesus, and everything changed. In time, Paul began to travel and teach about Jesus, starting new churches everywhere he went.
Even though Paul hadn't been to Rome yet, he knew a strong group of believers had formed there.
So, Paul wrote a letter to encourage the Romans and tell them he hoped to visit soon.
Which is where our story starts.
Take it away.
Hey everyone, I'm Brian. The letter that Paul wrote to the Romans does an amazing job of sharing what it truly looks like to follow Jesus. Now, Paul hadn't even visited Rome yet, but he knew the church there included both Jewish and non-Jewish believers, and that there might be some tension between the two groups. So, Paul wrote this.
If possible, live in peace with everyone. Do that as much as you can.
Okay, let's be real. For now, we live in a broken world. There's not a lot of peace anywhere. On the news?
Close of business yesterday.
On the playground?
Around 9:20 a.m.
Maybe even in your own family.
Stop!
But before we can make peace, we have to know what it is. Now, lots of people think peace is any time two people or groups are not actively fighting each other.
Your father smelt of elderberries.
Oh, whatever.
We also use peace to mean just a moment of calm. And I bet you've heard your grown-up plead, "Can I get some peace and quiet, please?" But true peace, the kind Paul wrote about, means a lot more than just no fighting. real peace means choosing to listen to the person or people on the other side. It means showing you care more about someone than about winning an argument with them. And Paul said that we should live in peace with everyone. You know who that leaves out? Nobody. Your goal is to live in peace with your little sister, with the kid in your class who thinks he's always right, with the coach who kept you on the sidelines nearly the whole game. That's a tall order, I know. And Paul knew it because he added this: live in peace as much as you can. Have you ever tried to make somebody else do what you want them to do? Yeah, good luck with that. You can't control what others do, but you can control you. When somebody says or does something that makes you angry, your first instinct is probably to fight back. They shove you, so you shove them. They call you a name, blah, blah, blah. So you call them a worse name, blah, 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 blah. But fighting back that way, it's like feeding a fire. Have you ever watched somebody build a bonfire? The fire starts with little sticks for kindling. And if you don't add more sticks, the fire will just die out, right? But if you do add more sticks, and more sticks, and more sticks, you end up with a giant wildfire. Pushing or yelling back is like adding more fuel to a fire. The situation quickly gets worse until it gets out of control, and you both get hurt. But when you choose to control your words and actions, you show you have the true power of peace. The other person has nothing to fight back against. And eventually the fire has to die down. Now, you should never let anybody bully you, but you can choose to tell someone in charge rather than trying to take on that bully yourself. You can also make peace by taking action. If you've had a fight or a friend or family member is not paying attention to you, go to them. Ask what's wrong and then really listen.
Is everything okay?
Yeah. No, I don't know.
You don't have to agree with them, but you can still make a way to restore the relationship. Now, not everybody will listen when you try to make peace. Some people will just stay mad, but you can still have peace inside as long as you've done everything that you can. Let's take one last look at our verse. If possible, live in peace with everyone. Do that as much as you can. After all, peace is not our idea, but God's. It's a gift that comes when we walk in step with Jesus and listen to God's Spirit. The end.
So, yeah, when I argue, it kind of goes forest fire.
It's way too easy to just say the first thing that pops into my head.
Yeah, choosing not to fight back is tough.
For reals.
So, what's our part in the story?
Well, peace is never easy, but it's much harder without Jesus. When you choose to follow Jesus, you can have peace with God, no matter who you are or what you've done. God sends the Holy Spirit to live within you, and God's Spirit helps good things to take root in your heart.
Things like peace.
Exactly.
But making peace is still hard.
Peace is a choice you have to make each day. Like if your little sister is sure it's her turn to pick the movie when you know it's yours, it's no big deal. Stop before it turns into a shouting match. Let her choose. Or ask your mom to decide.
Or if one of your friends is making you mad, don't react right away. Take a deep breath.
Then choose to really listen before you do any talking.
I think you got it. Peace. See you next time.
So, here's the thing. Make peace whenever you can.
You know what? I don't think we should call these battle bots.
Oh.
I think we should call them brew bots.
That's terrible. Or maybe awesome.
Thanks for joining us in the Story Lab.
See you next time.
See you next time.
Ready for a rematch?
Yeah.
I think we deserve it.
Let's do it.
Okay. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Battle!
Come on. Oh. Ah, wait a minute. No. Okay, that's fine. Come on, get him. Come on, Frederick Stein. Yep. You got this. Yep. Get right behind him. You're so close.
No. Tuppy.
Now they're just hugging.
Get him, Tuppy.
Wow, everybody. Paul told us to make peace with everyone as much as we can. God even has a lot of different names to help us understand how amazing he is and more about his character. One of those names is called Jehovah Shalom. Before we sit down and talk about what we just learned in Story Lab, let's watch a quick video that's really interesting on this name of God and what it has to do with peace. This month, we're learning about peace. And there's no one better to help us learn about peace than God. Did you know he even has a special name that means the Lord is peace? That name is Jehovah Shalom. You might remember last month that we learned about the name Yahweh, which is God's original name in Hebrew. When you translate the name Yahweh from Hebrew, it turns into Jehovah. So that's our name for God. But then what about the word Shalom? This word means peace, but Hebrew people would also use it sometimes instead of saying hello or goodbye. They were saying, peace to you. That's why when you say the name Jehovah Shalom, you're saying, the Lord is peace. And that's one of his special names to help us understand that peace isn't just something he can give us. Peace is something he is. It's part of his nature. As we keep learning about peace this month, let's remember this important truth. We can't have peace without God. He is Jehovah Shalom. Wow, I am so glad that God has such a wonderful name like this to help us understand that we can have peace in him. Alika is going to help us talk more about this now because it's group time.
What's up, people? It's Alika, and I got my boy Eli here, and it's time for group time! Whoa, group time! And freeze! How'd you guys freeze? What's up, you guys? It's group time, and I'm so excited to be here with you guys because this week we are going to be talking about making peace whenever you can. But Eli, before we do anything, we gotta talk about our memory verse. You ready for this?
Yeah.
So our memory verse is actually from Romans. It's Romans 12, 18. I want you to repeat after me. And friends, I want you guys to follow Eli just like he does. All right? Let's do this. You ready?
Yeah.
All right. So the memory verse is, if it is possible.
If it is possible.
As far as it depends on you.
As far as it depends on you.
Live in peace with everyone.
Live in peace with everyone.
So we're going to do this. We're going to go Romans
12:18.
Love it. Good job, bro. What? Let's do this. Huh? Okay, let's do it one more time. You ready?
Yep.
All right. Memory verse is Romans 12:18. Repeat after me, Eli and friends. If it is possible.
If it is possible.
As far as it depends on you.
As far as it depends on you.
Live in peace with everyone.
Live in peace with everyone.
Romans 12:18.
Romans 12:18.
That's what's up. Give yourself a hand. Good job, you guys. So this week, again, we're going to be talking about making peace whenever you can. But Eli, look, I got a question. You ready for some questions? Actually, I got a lot of questions, okay? My first question is this. If you could go anywhere, like anywhere in the world, anywhere. You got that?
Mm-hmm.
Like letting it sink in? Anywhere in the world, where would you go?
Probably Paris.
Paris. And why Paris?
Looks really cool and pretty.
Looks really cool and pretty? Like what do you feel like? Like what looks cool and pretty? Like
the
buildings and stuff?
Yeah.
Like the what's the tower thing? Is that in Paris? The tower? It's a tower, right? In Paris, I think?
I think
so too.
The Eiffel Tower.
The Eiffel Tower. Thank you, friends behind the camera! Eiffel Tower, right? I can't say it. But I know what you're talking about. Where else would you go? What would be option number two?
I would go to...
What'd you think?
Outer Banks again.
Outer Banks, North Carolina. That's a good spot. I know where that's at. Friends, I want you guys to think about it to yourself. Where would you guys go? If you could go anywhere in the world, where would that be? But let's talk about like peace, right, Eli? Because when I think about peace, I know for me, I'm like peace signs, you know, when I'm like, peace out. Can you do like a peace out? Do you do that? That's what's up. Or I'm like, peace, I think about like calm. Like, everything's good, right? Like, those kind of things. For you, Eli, why do you feel like maybe sometimes, or what do you think of when I say the word peace, or when you hear the word peace?
Like a peaceful place.
A place.
There's water running like a river.
Oh, so like sound, like shh.
Yeah.
There's a mic right now, that's what I did, like that. But like shh, like a river water kind of thing.
Yeah.
Got it. Dang, I need like one of those water fountains at my house. You know what I'm talking about? Like
yeah.
The electric ones?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you think about a place, that's good. I want you to remember that. What else do you think about when I say, or when you hear the word peace, what else do you think about?
Meditating.
Mm-hmm. Okay, love it. You said an action, meditating, and you said a place,
mm-hmm.
being like a place where you hear like sound.
Mm-hmm.
And I love that you said that, Eli, because every single one of us, we know what peace is, and we also kind of know like, oh man, I'm feeling really peaceful right now, mm-hmm. right? But I'm also like thinking like, and I want you guys to be thinking about this when you think of the word peace, because at the end of the day, we have peace on this earth because God sent Jesus, mm-hmm. right? And so it's like, man, we got to remember like, why we have peace is because of Jesus. But then it's also important to know, like you said, places maybe where you can find, where you feel like it's peaceful, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or like things like meditating. I love that you said meditating too, because something that I've been challenging my kids with is like, when you pray, I want you to try to find like that hidden place where it's just you and Jesus. It's just you and God, you know? So for Eli, as you're thinking about that, like the place with the river and the action being meditating, I want to encourage you, bro. Like whenever you're praying, is you literally in a peaceful setting with water running. Like if you can imagine that with Jesus. And that is a special place, okay? So don't forget that. Don't forget that, friends, okay? Why do you feel like it's so hard for some people to find peace?
Maybe they're like mad.
Yeah.
In certain ways.
Yeah.
Or like they might not be able to find it in certain ways because maybe they just don't know how to.
Yeah. You know what I think about? Because me and you were talking about video games right before we started recording, mm-hmm. right? Now don't laugh at me when I say this game, because it's not the games that you said. But I'm thinking about Mario, okay? Mm-hmm. And I'm thinking about Bowser, right? Is Bowser like a happy character or like an angry character?
Angry.
Right? Do you feel like Bowser like needs some peace?
Yeah.
Right? He needs a lot of peace, right? Bowser needs Jesus. That's what he needs, right? And that's the thing, when we read Romans, like we just did in 12:18, it says, if it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live in peace with everyone. When I think about the movie, have you seen Mario, the movie? The
new
movie?
Yeah.
Isn't it cool?
Yeah.
I think it's super cool. All Bowser needed to do was to find peace with everybody. You know what I mean? And that whole movie would have been totally different, right? But instead, he chose not to, okay? And I think like going in that, cause like, knowing the things that can stand in the way of having peace, like, okay, if I get angry or if I get mad, right? Maybe one of my friends did something that I didn't like, right? You knowing that, hold the phone, like, wait a minute. I am not at peace right now. I need to get peace. I need to control this emotion. I need to give this anger to God. I need to give this anger to Jesus, right? It's almost like, that is, for me and what I teach my kids, is that is one of the best solutions. It's like anytime you're at school, maybe you're with friends, maybe some of us have friends that make fun of us or crack jokes on us and we don't like it. Or maybe there's like, you know what I don't like, Eli? I don't like bullies. I do not like them. But God does. He still loves everybody. And it's not because they're a bully, but because he loves everyone. And so for me, it's like, man, if I know, if there's a bully at a school, at my school, I will have peace in knowing that God is with me, just like he's with you,
yeah.
wherever you go, right? Even when you play, what's your favorite video game?
Forza Motorsport.
Forza. How many Forza friends do we have? Like Forza fans do we have listening right now? Go ahead and put it down there in the comment section, okay? All right, here's my last question. Does making peace always mean you have to give up what you want?
No.
What do you feel like it means?
Well, sometimes it can mean that.
Yeah.
Like give up your friends if they're making you mad all the time.
Yeah.
But if you have like good friends, you can just make peace and have peace around them.
Yeah. A good way to think about it is, Eli, like if you did something wrong, is to ask for forgiveness. And if they do something wrong, is to quickly forgive. That's something I always love to share. So like, boom, if you have friends that hurt your feelings, it be quick to forgive. And if you hurt their feelings, be quick to ask for forgiveness. You cool with that?
Yeah.
I think that's a great solution. And I think that's a great way to end group time this week. Bro, you did fantastic. And before we end any group time, we're gonna make sure we pray. You cool with that?
Yeah.
All right, let's do that. Friends, join us in prayer. This has been an awesome week, and I hope you guys have a great rest of the week. Let's pray. Jesus, I thank you, God, for this day. Thank you for loving us and for helping us on this day and this week. God, when we're in any situations, whether we're angry or maybe we're doing things and it's not really going our way, Father, I ask that you help us to stop and to take a moment to calm down, to find the peace that only comes from you. Father, we love you. We thank you. We thank you for all your goodness in our life. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Peace. What up, everybody? My name is Ariel.
It's Tori.
And my name is Tiffany.
And today, we're going to be doing our memory verse together. Memorizing a verse of scripture is one of the best ways for us to open up our Bibles and learn about God.
Yeah, and how he wants us to live. So this month's verse is Romans 12, 18. Now remember, all of this month, we're learning about peace. And this verse can help us remember that God wants us to live in peace with everyone.
Let's start off by finding Romans in the Bible. Let's look for Romans in our table of contents. And let's see, mine is on page 2145.
Oh, well, mine is on 1024.
Wow.
And just remember that sometimes it depends on your Bible, so the table of contents might be different than your friends. So here's the thing. I'm gonna be looking for Romans 12, 18. So let's go ahead, turn in your Bibles to Romans 12, 18. That first number means chapter 12, and the second number means verse 18. So look for Romans with a big 12 and a small little 18.
Okay, there it is, right there. Now, I'm gonna take my bookmark and mark Romans 12. And it's okay if you don't have one, because you could always just use, you know, a sticky note. Tiff, you wanna take it from here?
Yeah, sure. Romans 12, 18 says, if it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. So this verse tells us that if it's possible to live at peace with someone, then we should do everything we can to do just that.
And that's exactly right. And I think that if we're gonna memorize this verse, we just need to be reading it every day.
Yeah.
That's your challenge this week. Each day, find this verse in your Bible and read it. This is gonna help you a bunch when we do the rest of our reading challenges this month.
Definitely. You can read it first thing in the morning or right before you go to bed, or it could be when you get home for the evening or just after dinner. The next time you're wondering what should you do or say in a situation, this verse will actually help you remember that you need to do your best to make peace. The better you memorize this verse, the more it can help you.
All right, we'll try a new activity next time. Now I think it's time for a little bit of
game.
Game
time.
So let's go see what we're playing today.
Hello everyone, welcome back to Game Time. And as you know, this month we're learning all about peace. So we're gonna play some high stress games to see if everyone can keep the peace. This week we're gonna play the human knot. Now if you're at a campus, grab 5 to 8 people in your group. And if you're at home, grab someone in your family or your neighbor or your friend. Let's get ready to play. Let's start the human knot. Okay, first thing, we're gonna grab as many hands as possible. You can't grab the hand that's next to you though. Y'all ready?
Aren't you supposed to just
I just wanna kinda close. Oh, is that what we're supposed to do?
We're gonna do this.
We're just gonna do this? Okay.
Sydney
okay.
And Carlos, over.
Over who, though?
Over everyone.
Okay. It's like one big hug.
Okay, and then Ashley over.
Do you go under me, Jordan?
Yes.
Okay. Nice. Okay.
I'm getting stressed out.
I'm just kidding. No, keep it
Ashley,
peace.
Wait, no. You go down.
Sydney?
Yep.
Oh, wait, so
whoa.
I need to go over?
Yep.
Whoa. Yeah. Arm down, put your arm down.
Okay.
Wait, let me go over you. Right?
I feel like go over their hands.
Okay.
And then Sydney.
Uh-huh.
So wait,
I go through.
Yeah.
Go through
nice.
There.
Okay.
Okay. Nice.
No.
And back.
Wait, Jordan is turning out.
Her elbow.
Ashley, calm down.
Okay. Oh, good. Oh, good.
Oh, wait, we need to free up Jordan. Yeah. Jordan is suffering right now.
And now I go over.
Oh, sorry,
and then
Jordan.
We go over.
We go over where?
I think if you go out that way, go under
here.
Yeah,
no, she has to go back.
I can't. Yeah,
you
can't.
Over.
Oh, and over. Then we all just go over.
Yeah.
That was really fun. How did you guys do? Did anyone get mad? Did you keep the peace? Did you get stressed out? I got a little stressed out, but we finished it in 1:10. I'm so excited to play a new game next week. I'll see you then. Bye.
Wow, everybody. We had so much fun learning about peace today. I'm so glad you could all be with us. Remember, VIPs, I have some special instructions for you. If it was your very first time here today, make sure to tell an adult in your house that there's a link below this video. It's just for them. They'll be able to give us some info so we can reach back out to you and say hi. All right, everybody, let's go ahead and pray. We want to make sure that we are being respectful to God and focusing on Him. So let's close our eyes, bow our heads as we talk to God. Here we go. God, thank you so much for helping us learn about peace. We love you so much. Help us always remember that you help us have peace. In Jesus' name, everyone said, amen.
Hello.
It's alive. It's alive. It's alive.
And it's delicious.
And welcome to
the So-and-So Show!
You're probably wondering what in the world are all these cables for? And you'd have every right to wonder that. Well, we are wired, hooked up, and connected to our own power grid. After looking at last month's power bill, John decided to take the studio offline. Oh, you bet I did. Brandon and I are plenty capable of making enough of our own energy to run the show. So, check. Is that working now? Yes, okay. I believe that we are up and running. Our sound is back on. Yeah, sorry about that. Like we were saying earlier, the entire show will now be run on kinetic energy. So every now and then, we'll just have to rev it back up. Okay, that should last us for the rest of the show. I hope so. Yeah. If it doesn't, I might have to brush up on my mime skills.
Thank you.
Now what's wrong?
Oh, sorry. It's the camera's batteries. All right, I just need to do a little quick recharge here. Ready?
You know, I was right in the middle of being trapped in a box.
Oh, I'm sorry. It was really good. And wow, look at you. You got out. Hooray!
That's not the point. The point is, this power thing is messing up the show.
You're right. It's terrible timing, but we should be good now. You can finish your performance thing.
No. I'm done, okay? No more miming. Oh.
We're good now. Shouldn't be any more problems.
No more problems, huh? Well, I guess we don't need lights.
Oh, is that what you think? No, we need
lights.
No,
that's not what I think. It's what I don't see.
I thought you might be a little more understanding when it comes to saving money.
I like saving money, but when you can't hear the show and you can't see the show, guess what?
What?
There's no show.
Okay, hold on. All right, here we go. Ready? One, two, three. You know, I thought you were fine with this whole kinetic energy thing.
I was, but how are we supposed to do a show when we keep having to stop and charge everything?
Oh, we? I haven't seen you helping.
What do you think I'm doing right now?
I don't know, I can't see
I'm
you.
I'm pedaling.
Well, good for you. And you know what?
What?
It's Bible story time with Kelly.
Fine.
Hey guys.
Hey.
Ooh, I'm sensing a little tension.
I don't know what would give you that idea.
Me either.
Just a hunch. Well, today's Bible story may be something you'll find interesting and hopefully helpful.
Sure.
Why not?
Great. Does that bike power my lights as well?
Does it, John?
Just keep pedaling.
Perfect.
Today's Bible story is actually just one verse from the book of Romans, which was a letter written by the Apostle Paul to the church in Rome. The letter was intended to provide direction, encouragement, and guidance to the community of believers. And I think Paul was trying to do all three of those things when he wrote this. If possible, live in peace with everyone. Do that as much as you can. Live in peace with everyone? Whoa! Easy for Paul to say. But then again, Paul had been thrown into jail multiple times for just talking about Jesus. And he was writing to people who could have been killed just for following Jesus. They were definitely living in a time that was not peaceful. So Paul wrote this letter to them. Even though people may be persecuting you, try as much as you can to live peacefully with them. Maybe that looks something like...
Do you like my new nails? I just did them.
They're pink.
Precociously pink. It's a new color. Do you like it, Ralph?
Looks purple to me.
Hey, isn't that your little brother?
Oh, yeah.
Give it to me.
No!
I want to turn!
When I'm done!
I want it now!
Get off me! I'm still riding it!
You're not gonna ride it anywhere! I would do something, but... My nails.
I got it. Get off me. I'm out of here.
Oh, no, you're not.
Ralph.
Hank, Sally, you guys can't fight. You're best friends. Now tell me what happened.
Sally started it.
Hank won't share.
She's not waiting her turn.
He's a tricycle hog.
You both have to share. Look, there's a way you can both have a turn at the same time. Right, Sally. You pedal, and Hank, you ride on the back. And when you get to the end of the road, you switch.
Sounds good to me.
Okay. Well, I guess this isn't too bad. It's like I'm on a chariot.
Hey, good job, Peacemaker Ralph. You'll be president someday.
Well, I'd rather be a YouTube star.
Hey, what's that?
Can we come back to talking about my nails? I want to ride on the chariot now.
Okay, it's pretty fun. Hang on. Let me turn around.
Ah. This is fun.
Hi-ho, Silver. Away!
Ralph was a good peacemaker. He saw two friends in trouble and he helped them work it out. And because he stepped in, Sally and Hank realized how much fun they have together. Peace really is a powerful thing. Okay, let's do one more. Sometimes when you're trying to work through conflict, you need to look at it from a different angle. And that's what these people did.
Welcome to Dance Battle, where enemies dance out their differences. First up, the powerful Pexter.
I'm Powerful Pexter, and I'm here to say my dance moves will make you pay. I may not be the biggest or the best, but my unstoppable flow is better than the rest. Watch me! The Powerful Pexter thinks he's got the gravy, but I wash him away, just like the wavy. I'm Mr. Wave, and my moves are like title. I'll wipe you out, just like a recital.
I'm Glidemaster. I spin.
Sometimes, when people have a conflict, they dance out their problems. Maybe not often, and maybe we all can't do that, but we can look for things that we have in common and start from there. Remember, Paul wrote, if possible, live in peace with everyone. Do that as much as you can.
Wow, I never knew making peace with someone could be so fun.
That's what's so incredible about peace. There are so many ways we can show each other we care. You see, peace helps you stay connected, which is way more important than winning an argument.
Hey, thanks. I think we needed that encouragement, or at least I did.
No, me too. And I'm sorry I made you do all these things just so I could save a few dollars.
No, I'm sorry. I should have been more understanding. Hmm. Peace.
Peace.
Well, I think my job is done here.
Hey, thanks for helping us stay connected.
You bet. And thank you for keeping me connected to power.
No problem.
Until next time, see ya.
Hey, by the way, how much money are we saving by doing this?
Oh, a lot.
Oh, good.
$6.
Reveal the question. Why is it important to make peace?
Yeah, because when you don't have peace, you're just not happy.
Yeah, and you can miss out on things that are really important, like friendship.
Yeah, in a good tricycle ride.
True. Hey, talk about it together. Why is it important to make peace? And we'll see you next time for a brand new show.
Are you still pedaling?
No.
Oh.
I don't like this. I don't like this.
No!
You're not supposed to speak.
Sorry.